Hey everyone, I'm Amanda with Suite Pieces, and we are here today to talk about waxing. One of our favorite things to do here at Suite Pieces, but I know from everything I've heard online and everything I hear from our customers, it's not one of your favorite things to do. So I'm gonna just talk to you about how easy this process should be, and if it's not easy, you're doing something wrong, and you need to come talk to either us or your local stockist, okay? Promise me you'll do that. So, waxing. What is wax? So wax is the second step to our wonderful two-step process of painting with anti-sullen chalk paint. It is going to seal your piece. It's going to give it a layer of shine and sheen and a layer of protection. It is not a high gloss finish, so kind of you got to keep that in mind. However, you can get a really gorgeous shine on it by doing some other stuff, which I'll talk to you about. So most people don't really understand what wax is because it really, even though it's been around for forever, and that's the way that we have been finishing furniture for a really, really long time, it's just not something that we're really used to. So let me talk to you a little bit about this. Basically, you wanna think of waxing like applying hand cream, okay? Waxing is not like applying a typical polyurethane type of top coat. Okay, so think of it like hand cream. So this is what we always talk to about our customers. So when you're putting on hand cream, do you go like this? You glob it on and then you stand there and let it dry? No, that's not how we do it. You put on enough on your hands and you kind of rub it in, you rub it all around. Maybe your elbow's a little bit more dry, you take a little bit more hand cream and you rub it in. That's how waxing should be. So let me show you how easy this should be. Now, I would highly recommend that you have a brush when you wax. Can you wax with a rag? Yes, you can. Now, some people love waxing with a rag. I personally don't like waxing with a rag at all. I find that the rag absorbs a lot of the wax. I find that if there's grooves and crevices of my brush strokes or any kind of ornate detail in the piece, it's very hard to get in there with a rag. So I prefer a brush. You should maybe try both and see which one you like better. So we have quite a few different options. Well, no, not really. It's a limited amount of options here at Suite Pieces. Of course, we carry the very best Annie Sloan's wax brushes, and these truly are the best. They are just very, very high quality brushes. They are a little bit of an investment, but I promise you that you will love these brushes once you have them. First of all, the handle on this brush is fantastic. You know, it's so easy to hold. You know, when you're holding a paintbrush, sometimes your hand is kind of a little bit more together. This kind of keeps your hand a little bit wider, and it doesn't hurt as much as, you know, when you're doing this for a long period of time. It also has this nice short handle, which is great for when you're working inside of, you know, tight quarters. Imagine if this was like a bookcase like this, it would be easy to do this. If I had a long handled brush, I wouldn't be able to do that. So it's a great brush, incredibly dense, has tons and tons of bristles. It also has a little bit of a tapered head. Now this brush has been used for a little bit. So sometimes we beat up on our brushes a little bit. There's a lot of different people using our brushes, so they do get worn down. When you have your own brushes at home, just be gentle with them. You know, you should be waxing in like a very nice sweeping motion. It shouldn't be like you're rubbing on the piece really super hard. I always say, if you put your hair in a ponytail and you scrub the table with it, don't you think that the hair will wear down eventually? It's exactly how it is with these brushes. So these are natural bristles, so you want to be gentle with them, and you don't have to work really hard to wax. It should be a really, really easy process. So two brushes, Annie's small and large wax brushes. They have that nice tapered head on them. Great to get into grooves and crevices of, you know, ornate detail and whatnot. We also carry, of course, Annie's paint brushes. You can use the same brush to paint and to wax. It is permitted. However, you just want to make sure that you clean it really well when you go from waxing back to painting. And if you need to know how to clean your brushes, go ahead and visit our other video on how to clean your brushes. So you can definitely use these brushes. Again, these are really incredibly dense. They have tons and tons of hair, which is great for really spreading that wax out and getting a nice even coat. So any of Annie's paint brushes. And then we also carry two other non-Annie options. You know, if your brush does not say Annie Sloan on it, It is not an anti-sullen brush, so make sure you're careful. You know, we want to make sure you know these are not anti-sullen brushes. Still good brushes, not quite as high quality as Annie's. So these are two not Annie's. This is called a Waxine. It has, again, a nice short handle on it. It's a little bit tapered, which is good. It has more of a flat head with your bristles, which is also nice. And then the other brush that we carry is this little petite waxing brush. Again, this does have a little bit of a taper to it. It's a little bit smaller. This is nice for small projects if you're doing like little picture frames or small little boxes, or even if you're just accenting with a little bit of dark wax or black wax or white wax, which we'll talk to you about in another video. This little petite waxing brush is great for that. So, okay, so there's your brushes. Now let's get to it. Let's show you how easy it is to wax. Personally, I don't really like to tell people this until they make their decision, but this is my favorite wax brush, the anti-sullen small wax brush. I really love the size of it. It fits nicely in my hand. It's got those nice tapered bristles on them, although this one is a little bit worn, but that's okay. I still love her. So here's your wax. So it looks kind of whitish, but it is totally clear, okay? This wax is not going to yellow over time. It's gonna stay completely clear, which is really, really nice. So I'm kind of dipping in here. I'm spreading out this wax on my brush. You know, you can see I don't have a ton of wax on my brush. You know, think of hand cream. When you start out, do you put gobs and gobs on? No, you start out with a little bit and you kind of get a feel for it. So now I'm gonna take this and I'm just gonna brush it onto my piece. Okay, so let me just brush this one area and then let you see. Now, I don't know if you can see this on camera, but do you see how this part of the gray stripe is a little darker and this is a little bit lighter? This doesn't have wax, this has wax. Now let me show you this. Let me try to do this. Okay. So now I'm just brushing this and there's probably hardly any wax on here. Do you see how this looks very uneven now? There's like these lighter sections and a little bit of darker. Those lighter spots don't have any wax on them. The darker areas do. So that means if you get an uneven finish like that with your waxing, that means there's no wax on some of those spots. So what's the cure? You just put a little bit more wax on your brush and you go back over it. Do you see how now that everything looks like one consistent color? That's how your wax should look. So I'm rubbing this in. I'm going in all different directions with my brush, just like hand cream. I'm not gonna see, you know, it's not like a typical top coat. You're not gonna see brush strokes like you would with a top coat because it's not really sitting on top. It's kind of absorbing into your paint. So you may have to go in all different directions because your brush strokes might be going in all different directions. So once I get that spread out on there, I'm now gonna take a rag. You can use most any rag, but you want it to be lint-free. You want it to be absorbent. And I like my rags have a little bit of texture to them. I don't personally like t-shirts because I find that they're too soft. So now I'm taking this and I'm removing any excess, and there really shouldn't be that much excess if you're applying the wax the correct way. So if you really have spread your wax out, whatever you put on your brush, if you really get that spread out, you really shouldn't have that much excess on here. So now do you see how, I'm not breaking my arm here. The goal is not to get tennis elbow when you're waxing, okay? You really shouldn't be working very, very hard. So I say we're polishing / removing any excess. Now, I don't know if you can see this on camera, but as I'm polishing this, I'm getting that nice shine on there, okay? It's not, if you look at this side, see how that's still very matte and chalky? I'm getting this nice shine that's building up over here. So I'm gonna continue across the way. And if you can see too, on this center stripe, there's some wax on here, and this part here is not waxed. So now I'm gonna go back over that. I'm gonna wax the whole thing.
So now that's basically how I wax. I wax in sections. Whatever I put on my brush, I get spread out into a small manageable area. And then I immediately take my rag or whatever, you know, this is a shop towel. We do carry these on our website and in the store. And I'm just gonna take this and I'm gonna polish slash remove any excess. So I'm just kind of rubbing this in. And you will have to kind of change out your rag every so often as it kind of gets clogged up with wax. You know, you can see there's a little bit of excess wax on here. So you should probably start with it like folded nicely, do an area, and then you can unfold it and go to a side that doesn't have wax and keep working. So now, once you have polished and buffed and pushed all your wax in, not doing it really hard, because we're not trying to get tennis elbow here, when you run your rag across the surface or your hand, it should glide smoothly. The rag shouldn't glide, it shouldn't stick. It shouldn't be like, it should just be gliding very smoothly across there. That's when you know you have removed enough of the wax. Now, you can immediately go over this section one more time with another quick coat of wax to just ensure that, yes, we have gotten our wax everywhere. We've really put a nice solid coat on here. You just want to make sure that anytime you apply wax, that you go ahead and do that polishing step and make sure that your wax is not feeling sticky or your rag is not gliding on there. So again, I'm turning my rag, I'm just kind of rubbing this down. The more layers of wax you put on here, the more durable it's going to be, the more shine you're going to get, and it's going to be super easy to maintain as well. Anytime we, this is a question we get in the store all the time too. Well, isn't wax hard to maintain? Don't you have to re-wax it like a lot? No, that's not true. I shouldn't say that. It really depends. If you really beat up on your pieces, you know, a quick coat of wax, and you see, you saw how quick that was. Any subsequent layers of wax that you put on your piece after the first coat are going to go on so much easier because it's not having to absorb into that paint. That initial absorption into the paint is going to kind of suck up a little bit more wax than any subsequent layers that you put on there. So you want to just kind of keep that in mind. It's going to be really easy to touch it up if you need to. You know, if you have a kitchen table or something, it shouldn't take you that long to throw another quick coat of wax on there. It should take 5 or 10 minutes. It's almost like, you know, cleaning it down, wiping it down. So it's very, very easy. What I love about the wax as well is that it's easily touched up. So if you get smudges, scratches, you know, whatever on any piece, you know, maybe you had a lamp there, you didn't let it cure for the 5 to 21 days that we recommend. You just stuck a lamp right back on there. Maybe it created a little indentation. You literally just take your wax, a little bit on your rag, and just buff out the spot, and it's completely fine. So it's so easy to touch up. If you had done polyurethane and you get like a chip or a scratch in your actual finish, you have to kind of redo that whole door. With chalk paint, it's so much easier to touch it up when you're using the wax as a top coat. The wax is incredibly durable. Once it cures and it hardens, it's on there. It has this beautiful shine to it that you just can't get with any other traditional top coat products. Just has that beautiful satin shine. It brings the paint to life. It just gives it this beautiful glow. It's fantastic. This is just a fun little box that we're doing for a library event, actually. So this is another board here. This was done in Napoleonic blue and Paris gray, and this was sanded a little bit. It's not a solid finish. So I'm just gonna take my brush, and you can see that the wax does kind of, it enhances the color a bit. You know, if you look at this, you should be able to see this really easily. This side has wax on it, this side does not. So see how much more vibrant that color is there than the other side? That's what the wax does. So sometimes a lot of people will say, oh, you know, the color doesn't look quite as dark as I thought. Well, once you wax it, it'll really kind of, you know, absorb in there and get really nice. So don't fret. Now this may not look completely consistent when it's done being waxed because it's not supposed to. It's been sanded and I'm seeing some of this color underneath, which is totally normal. So that's the key there. You want to make sure that you're getting the wax everywhere, that you're spreading it out evenly, that you're wiping slash polishing in any of the excess, and then you're gonna give it time to cure. So what does that mean? So that means, well, did you know that latex paints, traditional latex paints and top coats, they take time to cure too, about 30 days or so. I don't know if you've ever noticed, if you paint a piece of furniture with latex and you take your fingernail and you push it in, it will get indented. And that's because the latex is curing. So most any product is gonna take time to cure. Drying and curing are two different things. Your wax is gonna be dry within 24 hours. It's gonna cure. So each day that passes, it's gonna continue to harden for the next, say, 5 to 21 days, maybe a little bit longer if you've put on a lot of layers. The more layers, the longer the cure time. The more wax that's on there, the longer it's gonna take to cure. And basically what's happening over that time is that wax is really bonding with the paint, with the surface, and it's getting nice and hard, and it's getting nice and durable. So that means that you just wanna be gentle with your pieces during that day. You know, it's kind of when you bring a newborn home, you wanna just be a little bit more gentle with them than when they're, say, 1 or 2 year old. So same thing with your furniture. You're creating a fine piece of hand-painted furniture. You wanna treat it with love and respect. So maybe, you know, use coasters. If it's a kitchen table, maybe throw a tablecloth on it or placemats. You know, if it's your desk, maybe put a blotter on top of it. You wanna just, you know, protect it as much as you can. And again, if anything does happen during that cure time, then what's the cure? Well, really simple. You just get your rag out with a little bit of wax and buff out any sections that might, you know, have any imperfections in them. You will be so amazed. You'll think, oh my gosh, the finish is ruined. Just put a little wax on the rag and just try to buff it out. It'll come right out. Easy peasy. So, I mean, that's really it. We're gonna do another video on how to use the colored waxes, the dark wax, the black wax, the white wax, but this is just a basics on clear waxing. So see how nice and finished that looks now? It's got like a nice shine to it. It's really soft and smooth and easy peasy. It didn't take any time at all. So we talked about how to touch it up. You wanna make sure that you just, you know, work in sections. So even, I know we worked on some small pieces here today. You wanna work the same way as when you're working on a bigger piece. Work in a small section, whatever you put on your brush, get that all spread out, polish it, move to the next section. So, and again, it's not, you're not gonna see like overlapping lines because it's the same thing. If you do half your arm with hand cream and then the other half, you can't tell where the lines kind of overlap. It's the same concept with wax. So just have fun with it. It shouldn't be hard. Try to be very, very soft with your brush. You know, your bristles shouldn't be like bending obnoxiously. You should just be kind of like floating. Your wrist should be loose. And when you're done, you're gonna have this gorgeous, gorgeous piece of hand-painted furniture. Show us your pictures. We wanna see what you're working on. Send us an email, tag us on Instagram, Facebook, Pinterest, we're on all of them. Come visit us or come to the store, Huntington, Massapequa. We're out here on Long Island. We can't wait to meet you. You're gonna love this place. We'll see you soon.